On June 12th, Sunday, 2005, the day before the jury verdict of the Michael Jackson trial, I threw a tribute artist party here. Jackson family, and particularly for Michael Jackson. And I said at that time, the day before the Monday verdict, that Michael Jackson would be found not guilty of all charges. And certainly he was. But I had absolute faith, because I'd been at the trial every day for 5 months. This is building G behind me. This is where the Michael Jackson trial took place exactly 7 years ago on this day, on a Monday, 13th of June, 2005. A jury of mostly all white elderly people found Michael Jackson completely not guilty of all charges, because in fact, he was not guilty of all charges. Over that way is where Tom Mezzer used to come in and park. There was fences all around us, and all through the parking lot here, there was white canopies of media. The city owns this facility, not the county. Even though it was a county state trial, the city made money by renting these spots to the media, and they loved it. The longer the media stayed, they made extra bucks. All these spots where the cars are now used to have white media tents. That's all gone. The post holes are still where they had the fence to keep the public at bay. Still here, you can see that. The courthouse that you can see here, there's a new addition, but what you can see hasn't changed much. It looks very much the way it did 7 years. Also, what hasn't changed much is that Michael Jackson never got justice, even though he was found not guilty. Because when someone commits a felony in the courtroom like Tom Sneddon did, they should be held accountable. He should have been indicted. 7 years have gone by, and no one has made the slightest move to indict Tom Sneddon, Ron Zonen, and Gordy Auchincloss, and Wagener Nicola, the four prosecutors. Nobody has done a thing to get them indicted for their crimes recorded on the court record that virtually few people ever read. And even if they do, if they don't have a legal mind to understand what's been said and what's been proved and disproved, they wouldn't understand that at least three felonies were committed against Michael in that courtroom, in that courthouse right there. 7 years and still no justice. What I'm asking fans to do is to find a million fans that'll donate $20 so we can do a documentary that will put the pressure on, will expose the truth of how the media was 50% of the problem. They diminished every witness that was in Michael's favor, except once. And they played up the ridiculous accusations that were torn to shreds on cross-examination. Anyway, I thought you might want to look what it looks like today. 7 years ago, when that verdict was read.
Entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of conspiracy as charged in count one of the indictment, dated June 13th, 2005, for person number 80. Count two, verdict. We, the jury, in the above entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of a lewd act upon a minor child as charged in count two of the indictment, dated June 13, 2005, for person number 80. Find the defendant not guilty of providing alcoholic beverages to persons under the age of 21.
A woman stood over there. I know that woman. And she let go a dove. For every not guilty count, she let another dove go. There were hundreds of people, hundreds packed along that fence, and they were screaming. They were ecstatic.
Defendant not guilty of a lewd act upon a minor child. Count six, verdict. We, the jury, in the above entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of attempting to commit a lewd act upon a minor child as charged in count six. Count seven, verdict. We, the jury, in the above entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of administering an intoxicating agent to a count seven verdict, lesser offense. We, the jury, in the above entitled case, find the defendant not guilty of providing alcoholic beverages to...
I said for months before this verdict, months before, because I'd been in that courtroom every day for 5 months, I said, the jury will have to find him not guilty. I said, come on, Mr. Sneddon, show me one witness that's telling the truth, that saw Michael do anything wrong. Tell me, is there one? And in 5 months, that snake, Thomas Sneddon, could not find one witness that didn't get caught in their own lies. Janet Aviso was a B-grade actress, and she acted it out. And there were things that are not on the court record. The whole parking lot was filled with media trucks. And New England cable was broadcasting to a satellite from a truck right over here. This stop sign is where most people had to stop. Even the media had to stop here. There was a makeshift sort of fence here. And even the media had to come and get checked in daily to see if they were going to get permission to come into the courthouse, because there wasn't even enough room in the 50 seats for all the media people that wanted. Luckily, I was able to get in to the media every day. Peter Shafflin, who was the media coordinator, was good to me in that way. And then there's the media pool and the nasty little things they were doing to down Michael in the media pool. That's not on the court record, but I was there. I had a media press pass because I do a local television show for 5 years before that. Help us get justice for Michael. It's up to you. Yeah. There's still writing on the wall, literally. I love you, Mike. 6-7 years. 7 years ago here at Neverland, this place was jammed with hundreds of fans that had followed all the way back from the courthouse about 22 miles away to this rustic resort-like atmosphere, quiet, peaceful, where Michael had retreated from the lawyers and the scammers of Hollywood and Burbank, and he'd come out here to have peace of mind and to be left alone so he could dream and create without interference. Had Michael been convicted of even one misdemeanor charge of any kind of inappropriate conduct with children, he could never live here at Neverland, because there's a state law that you can't live within 1,000 feet of any school. And there's actually an official school right across Mount Figueroa Road, where I'm standing now on June 13th, 2012. So he wouldn't have ever been able to legally come back to Neverland. Just one charge, even a misdemeanor, and that would have been it for Michael. Normandy, near, French coast.
Yeah, near the D-Day beaches.
And what's your name?
Martina.
Martina, where are you from, Martina?
I'm from Black Forest.
Black Forest in southern Germany.